I'd like a big mansion in the forest. I'd like a really, really good car. Best car ever. Like my brother Praveen here, he's got a brilliant car. I'd like a brilliant car like him. I haven't got his car, but I'm happy in Jesus. But he's got a brilliant car, and praise God for it. But what God will meet your need. But we don't live on the material. We live in the spiritual, and God will be with us. Yeah.
Amen.
It's so important, because then we'll grow. We'll begin to grow. You can't grow on that kind of gospel. So number one, so the blessings of spiritual riches in Christ, He's called us to a clean life.
Amen.
Ephesians 1:4. Accordingly, He has chosen us in Him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before Him in love. Did you realize that God, the principal reason that why God has saved you is not just to get you to heaven. He saved you so that you'd be holy.
Amen.
He wants you to be holy. So when you're discouraged and you feel, I feel like packing this in, just think about, well, if you weren't Christian, what kind of lifestyle would you have lived? So, I ain't going down that line anymore, no. He's called me to be holy. This is a much better life than being in a pub and swearing, being in a pub and trying to sleep with someone I don't even know, or whatever. You know what I mean? Your life, your own life, you've been saved to be holy. It's a better life. You're being changed from glory to glory. That's the riches of Christ. You've been adopted, Ephesians 1:5, having predestined us unto the adoption of sons of Jesus Christ to Himself, according to the good pleasure of His will. You've been adopted into God's family. You're His child. And because you're His child, you have all the privileges of that adoption. If Pastor Praveen adopted and his wife adopted a little baby, that baby would inherit all of his title and all of what his family has. And you've been adopted into God's family, so you can never be feeling you're on your own and discouraged, because you've been adopted in the Lord, into the Lord's family.
Amen.
But as many as receive Him, to them He gave power to become the children of God, even to them that believe in His name. John 1:12, you're a child of God now. Whatever your circumstances tell you, you're a child of God. For you have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. Romans 8:15, you've been adopted into His family. He has revealed His plans to you. The Queen, imagine the Queen knocks on your door and says, hello, how are you doing? I'd like to show you my diary. And she opens up her diary and says, this is what I'm doing on Monday. This is what I'm doing on Tuesday. You'd be the first one to come to church and say, the Queen visited me. The Queen showed me her diary, and I know what she's doing next week. I know what she's doing next year. Well, guess what? God showed you His diary.
Amen.
He showed you His diary. He showed you what He's doing throughout history. He's revealed that to you.
Amen.
Ephesians 1:9. Look at it. Ephesians 1:9. Having made known unto us the mystery of His will, according to His good pleasure, which He has purposed in Himself, He's made known history to you.
Amen.
Verse 10. Look at this. That in the dispensation of the fullness of time, He might gather together in all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in Him. That a clever man like Plato and Aristotle would scratch their head and wonder, what is history all about? What is it all about? There are people like Kant and you, great philosophers, great thinkers, people who just recently died, Hawkins, and they tried to scratch their head the meaning of the universe, and God has revealed it to you and said, look, I am gathering a people and saving a people so they can worship me at the end of time, for all time. And I'm showing you what I'm doing in history. And you are privileged to know this plan. Whereas men have tried to find out and they can't by reason, but you have been given it as a child of God. God has shown you His diary.
Amen.
And then finally, we have an inheritance. Ephesians 1 verse 11. In whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of Him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will. There's an inheritance, eternal inheritance, my friend. Verse 18. The eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory, here it is, of his inheritance in the saints. So, you might struggle. We all struggle. Anybody here who doesn't struggle, you're basically deluded if you don't have trouble and difficulties. You're just on planet Mars. Everybody has problems. Everybody struggles. Everybody finds it difficult at times. Even the best of men and the best of women. But he's given you spiritual riches. He's called you to a clean life, and it was better than the old life.
Amen.
He's adopted you into his family. You're now his child. He's shown you his plans for history. And he's given you a great inheritance. Mm. 1 John chapter 3 verse 2. Beloved, now we are the children of God. And it does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him. For we shall see him as he is. Oh, my friends, all this world is passing away. All its fame and all its glory and all the razzmatazz and dazzle of this world is passing away. And all the riches of heaven are there, but nobody can see it but those who have had their eyes open. And all that is yours. Seek it. Seek it all. Seek all of it. Seek all those treasures. Appropriate all that Christ has for you. Run the gauntlet. Run the race. And pursue the riches of Christ. Pursue them. All the glory that he has for you. All the riches of heaven for you. You can be poor. You can be weak. But you can be rich in Christ. It's all there for you. Imagine, we come to the conclusion now, final end. Imagine you had porridge every day. Porridge for breakfast, porridge for dinner, and porridge for tea. And your mama and your papa were giving you porridge every day, and you were eating it for a year, you'd be sick of porridge, wouldn't you? Mm. You say, oh, mama mia, can I have something better than porridge? Porridge every day. You go to bed, you think, I'm fed up of porridge. And sometimes in our life, with the rigmarole of life, some of you have got tough lives because you're working and you've got family and it's not easy. And you've got this cycle and it's a treadmill and you think, oh. It's like eating porridge every day. It's the same old thing, same thing, same thing. Oh, where's the spice in life? Where's the excitement in life? Oh, yeah, it's like eating porridge every day. One day you say, Mama, Dad, I'm sick of this porridge. Could I have a Chinese? Could I have a curry? Could we go down to the curry house and just have a bit of spice? Or Daddy, could I just go and have a nice steak and chips? Ephesians chapter 1 is your spice in life.
Amen.
That's how you get out of the rigmarole of the same old thing in your life. You pursue the riches of his grace.
Amen.
We've touched on topics that you could spend weeks on. Election, chosen, adoption. We haven't even got into the sealing of the Spirit. My friend, the word is so deep, so rich. Oh, give me that word, better than any philosophy book. Better than any book in the world. You cannot plummet the depths of this book. It is so rich and so wonderful. And we've only touched on a few things. So, it says in Philippians chapter 4, verse 19, Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. But my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus.
Amen.
So we just finished with one quick lesson. One quick lesson. It's a very important lesson. When you've got a need, when you've got a problem, when you've got a challenge, don't demand from God from you. You know, like, say you've got a problem, you say, God, you owe me. I've kind of like done stuff for you, so I need you to sort this problem out because I did this for you, I did that for you, So you do that for me. You're going in your name. And your name ain't good enough because you're a fallen person. You're not perfect. You're a sinner. So it ain't gonna cut any ice with God. But do you remember that Christ, when he died and he rose again, he's purchased all the riches of heaven for you. So when you come before God and you have a problem, you say, Father, in the name of Jesus, will you help me in this situation? And because of Jesus has purchased all the riches of heaven, all the power and the glory of God comes behind your problem and stands with you in that situation. Because you say it in the name of Jesus. Okay? God bless you.
Amen.
Everybody say Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Could you stand up and we're worshiping last songs and we're offering offerings.